In the quest to combat poverty in rural Kakumiri district, Harriet Sally Tiburiwe, a dedicated NRM mobilizer, has rallied locals into a savings trust group. Their goal? To save for economic transformation and upliftment.
Some of our people are not yet at it. They are not yet at it. Why? Some people, when they hear about community mobilization, or community development, some people tend to scare away. Some people think that those people are coming to give loans, and after which they will go and arrest them.
Established 6 months ago, this trust group operates on a unique model. Members pull together monthly contributions, which are then invested in income-generating projects chosen collectively. What sets this group apart is its accessibility. Members can easily access development funds without traditional collateral requirements based on community trust and support. During a visit to Robert Subiri's home, the group celebrated a significant milestone. They successfully raised over 6 million shillings, a testament to their dedication to self-sufficiency.
The loans people have been giving, instead they come and join this one the next day. Your name shall be read and you'll come here to pick your money. Even the next month like this, another person will get. The other month, another person like that. So people are no longer believing in loans, these community-based loans. Even some are no longer going to the bank. Now, like today, the person they have given money today has received 6 million. Parish Development Model is giving us 1 million.
The trust group's operational mode revolves around collecting funds from the sale of agricultural produce. Every member receives a portion of the pooled fund, providing a launchpad for those without existing income-generating activities to kickstart their projects.
The message I have to my members, it is working hard and putting much effort in the thing that we are in.
Through innovative initiatives like this, Kakumiro is witnessing tangible development outcomes. The trust group stands as a beacon of hope, guiding locals towards economic independence and prosperity. Story compiled by Rachel Nachwala for the news.